Hey, welcome everyone. How are you doing? Fantastica. Hello. KJ, Petey Gray. What's up, everyone? Gonna be a hell of a week. Hope everyone is ready for some game overs. Fail count has returned for this one. I'll grin and bear it. Gonna be high. I might even need to move it to the left to make room for the numbers. But we'll see. Iceman, what's up?
The Iceman cometh.
If anyone sees that dude Coot today too, gotta pick his brain about getting a sound effect going. Oh, I don't think he made it into Discord yet. I lost the commands that I'd set up, changed for Discord the other day when Ankhbot corrupted and pulled it from a backup. I think I got him remade, but...
The nuclear weapons disposal facility on Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago was attacked and captured by Next Generation Special Forces, being led by members of Foxhound. They're demanding that the government turn over the remains of Big Boss, and they say that if their demands are not met within 24 hours, they'll launch a nuclear weapon. You'll have two mission objectives. First, you're to rescue DARPA Chief Donald Anderson and the president of Armstech, Kenneth Baker. Both are being held as hostages. Secondly, you're to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the ability to make a nuclear strike and stop them if they do.
What's the insertion method?
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub.
And then?
We'll launch a one-man SDV. After the SDV gets as close as it can, dispose of it. From there on, you'll have to swim. High-tech Special Forces Unit Foxhound. Your former unit, and one that I was a commander of.
So they're still around.
There are six members of Foxhound involved in this terrorist activity. Psycho Mantis, with his powerful psychic abilities. Sniper Wolf, the beautiful and deadly sharpshooter. Decoy Octopus, master of disguise. Vulcan Raven, giant and shaman. And Revolver Ocelot, specialist in interrogation and a formidable gunfighter. And finally, in charge of them, Foxhound squad leader, Liquid Snake.
Liquid Snake.
The man with the same code name as you. The nuclear weapons disposal facility covers the whole island. I'll instruct you by codec after you reach your target.
Anyone going with me?
As usual, this is a one-man infiltration mission.
Weapons and equipment OSP?
Yes. This is a top secret black op. Don't expect any official support.
A lot of that, some of that, maybe most of that, will actually get replayed. I have only played Metal Gear Solid once. Once, it was here on stream, it wasn't that long ago. A mono TV? Mono TV? The PS1 didn't have a lot of cinematic games. This changed the industry. This game was so cinematic, it set the bar. It did some amazing things with the PS1. First person view. The controller for the PS3 PS1, PS2, PS3, did they all have pressure-sensitive buttons, or when was that introduced? I know that comes into play in MGS2. Did the original DualShock didn't have pressure-sensitive face buttons, did it? Weapon crawl action. Stick with the standard controls. I'll have to get used to it again. I'm not very good at this game, and I've only played it once. Watched it many times, but only played it once. It was on normal, on hard. There are quite a few changes. The biggest change for me is probably going to be the radar. I'll take more damage. That'll suck. I'll do less damage. That'll suck. Boss fights are going to be a lot harder. And they were hard enough. I think it was a PS2 thing. Fantastica. Okay, that makes sense. On PS3, you can get the HD collection, which comes with MGS 2 and 3, the HD versions of them. Playing 60 FPS, 720, they're gorgeous. They do not let you use the DualShock 4, they require some of the features of the DualShock 3. In particular, it's the pressure-sensitive face buttons, I believe. Briefing. When I played this before, we went through all the different briefings. And again, some of these overlap, so I don't know if we'll go through them all here. TYB, how you doing? How was your birthday yesterday?
I should have known you were behind this, Colonel.
That's no way to greet an old war buddy, Snake.
What do you want from me?
I just invited you here so we could have a talk.
Invited? That's what you call sending armed soldiers after me?
Sorry if they were a little rough with you. But we've got a serious situation here. Only you can get us out of it.
I'm retired from Foxhound. You're not my commander anymore, and I don't have to take orders from you or anyone else.
You will take these orders. I know it.
Excuse me.
Who's this?
Dr. Naomi Hunter. She's chief of Foxhound's medical staff, and an expert in gene therapy.
Are you military?
No, civilian. I've been sent here from ATGC. Pleasure to meet you, Snake. Don't worry. This injection won't hurt a bit.
What's the shot for?
What's wrong? You don't like shots?
Snake, listen up. It all went down 5 hours ago. Heavily armed soldiers occupied Shadow Moses Island. A remote island off the coast of Alaska.
What soldiers?
Next generation special forces, led by members of Unit Foxhound. They've presented Washington with a single demand, and they say that if it isn't met, they'll launch a nuclear weapon.
A nuclear weapon?
I'm afraid so. You see, the island is the site of a secret nuclear weapons disposal facility.
Foxhound hijacking a nuclear weapon?
Now you understand how serious the situation is. You'll have two mission objectives. First, you're to rescue the DARPA chief, Donald Anderson, and the president of ArmsTech, Kenneth Baker. They're both being held as hostages.
Those are some heavy-duty hostages.
Secondly, you're to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the ability to launch a nuclear strike, and stop them if they do. Any questions, Snake?
Questions? I haven't even said whether I'd accept this mission.
Well, you can make up your mind after you hear more about the situation.
Briefing file, and then they give you a bunch more you can go through. What do you think? Should we go through all the briefings, or jump in? You're gonna get some briefing overlap no matter what when we start the game. Mission description, infiltration method. We check them out? I'm not in any rush. Let's say hello. Let's talk about this week, what's going on next week, what's going on, scheduling, a little bit of scheduling. Welcome everyone, again, by the way, if you just got here, welcome. Be playing Metal Gear Solid all week. It's gonna be painful. It's gonna be painful. I played 1 and 2 for the first time on stream not too long ago. And that was on normal. I'm gonna be raising the difficulty for each of them. So 1 and 2 on hard and 3 on extreme. I don't know how long they're gonna take. Some of you were here for the previous playthrough, so you know, this could take a while. I think it was about 18 hours on MGS-1, probably that or a little longer on 2, and then it's about 30 hours for MGS-3. So the schedule that I have laid out goes through next Tuesday, and then is just open. I don't know how long this is going to take. We may not be done with this a week from today. I'm expecting today and tomorrow on MGS-1. And it might spill over onto Thursday. Thursday, Friday, and maybe part of Saturday for MGS-2. And then Saturday, Tuesday, and maybe part of Wednesday or Thursday next week. I don't know, for MGS-3. After that, we're probably going to go on to The Witcher. Will it be the first Witcher? Going back to the first Witcher? Will I change my mind at the last minute and feel like continuing Hearts of Stone NG Plus right now, you know, at the end of MGS? So just a heads up, I'm not going to fill in the schedule until we're closer to the end of this MGS run. By the way, if you're a big Metal Gear Solid fan and you really want to see it done right, you're not going to see it done right here. You're going to see a lot of fails, and hopefully it'll be a really good time. But if you want to see it done right, you need to check out Outer Heaven here on Twitch. OHN, formerly known as United, but the Outer Heaven Network, 3 streamers. They are doing a month-long marathon right now. Every game in the series, hardest difficulties, round and round again. Story runs, challenge runs, a bit of everything. But they do everything, and they do it right. It is a little crazy over there. Sometimes there are thousands of people watching at a time. Chat is absolutely nuts. But if you really want to see the most that you possibly can of Metal Gear Solid, you need to check out Outer Heaven here on Twitch. You're here for the fails and the fun? Good. There will be lots of both. Let's do the briefings. I'm in no rush. That was sort of the point. We're going to be here all week, not trying to force the game into a particular pace here.
Colonel, I don't work for the government anymore. Let me go back to Twin Lakes.
Why, Snake? Is your life in Alaska all that great?
There's a dog sled race this week. Next Saturday, I have to be in Anchorage.
Yeah, Dinnerod? The longest sled race in the world? When did you become a dog musher?
Right now, my 50 huskies are my only family. I've got to take care of them.
Don't worry about your dogs.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, Snake, but this vessel is headed for the Bering Sea. There's no room for debate.
I told you. Even if I do owe you, I don't owe anything to this army or this country.
You will accept this assignment.
Why should I be stupid enough to do that? I'm no patriot.
Snake, there's enough dirt in your file from your days as an agent to keep you in the stockade until you're a very old man.
Oh, I see. Blackmail.
No, Snake. I prefer to look at it as helping you come to a decision more easily. But anyway, I know you better than that. You'd take this assignment even without the threat.
Why do you say that?
You're a natural-born soldier. You're not the grow-old gracefully type. It's the same for all of us who've seen real action. The only place we can feel truly alive is on the battlefield. I'm a soldier, too. I know those feelings of powerlessness, frustration that you feel every day. You've tried to play the Boy Scout out there in Alaska, but you can't race dogs in the snow forever. Why don't you come back to us? And be a soldier again.
You think my life is some kind of a joke?
Snake, I just want to give you back your purpose in life.
Wombat, what's up? Yes. Briefing file. I did not get into the briefing file. I exited accidentally and it played one more briefing file. I didn't get to the ones in the middle yet.
Nuclear weapon disposal facility.
A lot of order.
The disposal facility includes a hardened underground base. Even with our most advanced intelligence gathering equipment, we can't tell what's happening inside.
So someone needs to penetrate, gather intelligence, and report back. Sounds like a spy movie. What's the insertion method?
Well, an air insertion is impossible.
Not with this storm going on.
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub.
Approach?
Yes, within a few miles of it. The facility is equipped with sonar detection capabilities. They'd be able to hear our engine or propeller noise.
And then?
we'll launch a one-man SDV.
Launch?
Same as a torpedo, only this has no propulsion device of its own. After the SDV gets as close as it can, dispose of it. From there on, you'll have to swim.
You want me to swim in sub-zero Alaskan water?
Don't worry. That suit represents the latest advances in polythermal technology. The nuclear weapons disposal facility covers the whole island. I'll instruct you by codec after you reach your target.
Anyone going with me?
As usual, this is a one-man infiltration mission.
Yep, on that.
Weapons and equipment OSP?
Yes. This is a top-secret black op. Don't expect any official support.
There's so many things to talk about in this game, so there'll be lots of opportunities to do that. I don't want to interrupt too much of the briefing file here. The amount of information, lore, and dialogue in this game is off the charts.
They say they'll launch after 24 hours.
Especially for when it was made.
Do they say what the target will be?
So far, they haven't mentioned the target.
When did the countdown start?
5 hours ago.
Haven't even hit start yet. We get to spend half an hour on the menu finding out about the game and the characters before you even hit start. Pretty sweet. Kim, what's up? Good morning.
Who are you speaking for?
Naturally, I'm representing the US government.
So who's in supervisory control of this operation?
The President of the United States.
Which means that the President must be meeting with his top aides in the map room about now, huh?
No, at this point they're still video conferencing with each other.
If that's a real nuclear warhead, shouldn't they issue a COG?
Not yet. The Secretary of Defense has operational control and is fully aware of the situation. After you infiltrate, if you determine they possess nuclear launch capabilities, a COG will be issued.
Well, if they haven't relocated to the nuclear shelter under Mount Washington, I suppose there isn't that much reason to worry yet. Is the National Security Agency in on this?
Yes. So is the DIA, the Defense Intelligence Agency.
The DIA? I'm starting to get a bad feeling about this.
They'll be sending us some support.
We don't need desk jockeys. We need a nuclear weapons specialist.
Of course. A nuclear weapons specialist has already been assigned to us.
Sequoir, what's that? Was that something in the briefing he mentioned that you were asking about? I might have actually missed something there. Yeah, Semper Last says, how are you? We haven't even hit start yet.
We need backup from a specialist.
Let it play out.
I'm just amateur when it comes to nuclear weapons.
I know. That's why I've requested the assistance of a military analyst named Nastasha Romanenko. She'll be providing you backup by codec.
A female analyst?
She's built up an impressive record as an advisor for the nuclear emergency search team. Contact her if you have any questions. She's also an expert on high-tech weapons.
Where's she working from?
At her home in Los Angeles.
California. Seems like a million miles away. Colonel, you're retired. Why are you involved in this?
Because there aren't many people who know Foxhound as well as I do.
Is that really the only reason?
I've been soldiering for a long time. I don't know anything else. I guess even though I'm getting a little old, I still love to be in the field.
Colonel, you're a lousy liar. Tell me the real reason.
Okay, Snake. Sorry. I'll be frank. A person very dear to me is being held hostage.
Who is it?
My niece, Meryl.
I don't want to talk over these briefings. They may not all make sense, but we're going to get to know a lot about all of these topics. If you've never played or seen Metal Gear before, it has a tremendous amount of voiced lore in the game, more than any game at the time, more than many games since. We will be speaking with Campbell quite a bit. We will be getting a lot of information from these other people who are being mentioned. We will be finding out a lot about how does that apply to this scenario. It's a little early to get into that. You're gonna hear your answer and a lot more. How does this apply to this scenario? Well, there's a group with the possibility of setting off a nuke, and their intentions are unknown. So depending on what they were to do with that nuke, and this is, it's really too early to get into it, but depending on what they do with that nuke, there might need to be provisions in place for what to do. It can be very convoluted. We're not gonna be able to lay it all out and make sense of it right away. It's not gonna make sense right away. Metal Gear has a reputation of being pretty complicated. It has a lot of social, political, technological commentary. Very different from something like Deus Ex, which we just went through. But nuclear deterrence, nuclear proliferation, references to Cold War and post-Cold War government conflicts. It's a mix of references to actual history, but it's completely fabricated in its own presentation of the story.
What was your name?
We're gonna have lots of chances to talk about it. We won't
several
be able to talk about it all up front.
Missing the day of the revolt, and my niece was one of those called in as an emergency replacement.
She looks like you.
She's my little brother's girl. He died in the Gulf War. Since then, I've been watching after her.
A personal motive, Colonel. That's not very soldierly.
I'm retired. I'm just an old man now. And I'm your friend.
Since when are we friends?
I've thought of us as friends since the fall of Zanzibar.
With my personality, I don't have too many friends.
That's what I trust about you. It's what makes you human. Please, Snake. Save my niece, Meryl.
All right, but I have two conditions.
Name them.
One, no more secrets between us. I want complete disclosure at all times. And two, I'll only accept orders directly from you, Colonel. No cutoffs involved, okay?
Agreed. That's why I was called. But one thing.
What?
I'm not a colonel anymore, just a retired old warhorse.
I understand, Colonel.
The chronology of Metal Gear, the character relationships, explaining the characters, where they came from, the chronology of the story, which is different than the release order of the games by quite a bit, is very confusing. We'll come back to it. But in short, Snake, a lot of people who are unfamiliar with the Metal Gear Solid series, one of the first things they get confused by is who the heck is Snake, because there are quite a few characters who use the codename Snake in the Metal Gear Solid series. This was the first Metal Gear Solid game, 1998. Solid Snake. We're going to be playing as Solid Snake. Solid Snake existed in the previous games. Before Metal Gear Solid, there was Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2. Kojima, the mastermind of this series, made those games for the MSX, a Japanese computer system. And then the Nintendo port of Metal Gear, the NES Nintendo port, was actually quite a different game, and it was the sequel to that on Nintendo, which was so dreadful. After that, Kojima went and completed his own Metal Gear 2, Solid Snake. So the character of Solid Snake exists from the previous games. However, this Metal Gear Solid has some different meanings. He already had that name, Solid Snake, but Solid you could think of it as a 3D game. The characters have moved from 2D into something feeling more solid. I don't wanna. Well, there you go, DJ. There's the chronology laid out. I'm not gonna lay it all out, read that out here. We'll get back to it. But Solid Snake is in Metal Gear Solid 1 and 2 and 4, but 3 goes back. Actually, yeah, it begins in 1964 for Snake Eater. That's unreadable. Well, it's not unreadable, but it is a little mashed. So Snake, there's Big Boss, it's not Solid Snake. Naked Snake. These are code names. Snake is a code name. Snake is, of course, not a proper name. And Naked Snake, Big Boss, is not in this game. Solid Snake is who we will be playing here. That doctor, keep stopping myself from saying too much too soon. We'll put it in context and get a chance. Gene therapy.
She knows more about those men than anyone else. You mean you've seen them naked?
Make no mistake, I'm not a nurse. I'm a scientist.
By the way, what was that injection for?
It's a combination of nanomachines and an anti-freezing peptide so that your blood and other bodily fluids don't freeze, even at sub-arctic temperatures.
Nanomachines?
Not just one kind, either. There are different types which will replenish the supply of adrenaline, nutrition, and sugar in your bloodstream.
Now I don't have to worry about food.
I also put some nootropics in there.
Say what?
Nootropics. A class of drugs which will help improve your mental functioning.
It'll make me smarter, huh? Anything else?
Yes. Benzedrine. It's a type of stimulant. It'll keep you alert and responsive for 12 straight hours.
That was quite a cocktail. Anything else in there?
Those nanomachines will also keep your codex batteries charged up.
I guess I can call you when I'm ready to go on a diet.
You're welcome.
The chief of DARPA and the president of an arms manufacturing company. What business did they have at a nuclear weapons disposal facility?
The truth is that secret exercises were being conducted at the time the terrorist group attacked.
Must be extremely important exercises if those two were directly involved. Were they testing some kind of new advanced weapon?
I'm not privy to that information.
Do we know exactly where they're being held?
The DARPA chief has also been injected with a mini transmitter. As you get closer, you should be able to pick up his location on your radar.
Procyon, that's all pretty interesting. I'm not going to interject the briefing with that right now, but it's a good point. Similar criticisms are leveled at the series quite a bit.
Do they really have the ability to launch a nuclear missile?
They say they do. They even gave us the serial number of the warhead they plan to use.
Was the number confirmed?
I'm afraid so. At the very least, they've got their hands on a real nuclear warhead.
Isn't there some kind of safety device to prevent this type of terrorism?
Yes. Every missile and warhead in our arsenal is equipped with a PAL, which uses a discrete detonation code.
PAL?
Permissive Action Link. The safety control system built into all nuclear weapons systems. But even so, we can't rest easy.
Why not?
Because the DARPA chief knows the detonation code.
But even if they have a nuclear warhead, it must have been removed from its missile. All the missiles on these disposal sites are supposed to be dismantled. It's not that easy to get your hands on an ICBM.
That used to be true. But since the end of the Cold War, you can get anything if you have enough money and the right connections.
Buffy.
How well armed are these terrorists? I know there was an exercise going on at the time they revolted.
They're heavily armed, I'm afraid.
What about their battle experience?
The six members of Foxhound in charge are all hardened veterans. They're tough enough to eat nails and ask for seconds.
I wouldn't expect anything less from Foxhound.
The others are next generation special forces. They're not your average grunts either.
Thank you.
what exactly are they demanding?
A person's remains.
Remains?
That's right. To be more accurate, cell specimens which contained the individual's genomic information.
Cell specimens? Why would they want that?
The terrorists need them. You see, these next-generation special forces have been strengthened through gene therapy.
Strengthened?
You've heard of the Human Genome Project. They've been mapping the human genome, and they're nearly finished. Following up on this research, the military has been working towards identifying those genes which are responsible for making effective soldiers.
There are genes that do that?
Yes. And using gene therapy, they're able to transplant those genes into regular soldiers.
Gene therapy?
I'll explain this part. With gene therapy, we can remove those genes which we know may lead to sickness or disease, and at the same time, splice in genes with beneficial effects, such as resistance to cancer, for example.
In other words, we can overcome all sorts of genetic diseases, and at the same time, add genetic characteristics as desired.
Okay. And so if you knew what genes were responsible for making the perfect soldier, you could implant them in the same way, right?
Yes, we could.
But it all depends on being able to isolate and identify those soldier genes.
And in order to do that, it's helpful if you can study the genomic information of one of the greatest soldiers ever.
Hey, old Snake, how are you? I'm pretty sure you can't do anything with the camera in this one, in the original, during briefings and calls.
One of the greatest soldiers
pretty
ever.
Trolly how it looks the like it's this many entries and then it keeps expanding century. As you go.
You don't mean Big Boss.
Big That's Boss? Right.
We've been working feverishly to identify the genes responsible for his incredible
He is indeed,
skill.
DJ.
So far we've discovered about 60 of the so-called soldier genes.
So his body was recovered after all.
Yes, and his cells have remained frozen in a cryo chamber. His genomic information is a priceless treasure to mankind.
Priceless to the military, perhaps.
His body was burned severely, but it was possible to restore his DNA profile from just a single strand of his hair.
You people are amazing. And then you're gonna transplant those genes into soldiers?
Yes. We'll use a process that I discovered called gene targeting. The strongest soldiers don't become what they are by acquiring their skills through training or experience. We now know that hereditary factors are far more crucial for creating superior soldiers.
Snake, we can't give them his body. It's potentially more dangerous than all the nuclear warheads on that island put together.
I hear the terrorists are calling themselves the Sons of Big Boss.
The Sons of Big Boss?
Sons of Big Boss. Metal Gear. Even if you're not absorbing all this, if this is your first time seeing it, just let it wash over you. It'll click later.
They started out as
maybe.
An anti-terrorist special
possibly.
Ops unit, made up of former members of biochem units, technical escort units, and the nuclear emergency surge team. Their purpose was to respond to threats involving next-generation weapons of mass destruction, including NBC weapons.
Until they were added, that is.
Who's they?
These guys didn't start out as regular army.
Looks like a pretty international group. Mercenaries?
Yeah, and it gets worse. Most of them were from a merc agency that I think you're familiar with. They were part of Big Boss's private guard. And after Big Boss went down, the military just bought out all their contracts.
Outer Heaven.
After that, they were merged with our own VR unit, Force 21, and retrained. If you ask me, these so-called next-generation special forces should be called simulated soldiers. They have no real battle experience.
Video game players, huh?
Don't forget they've all been strengthened with gene therapy. They carry genes which make them excellent soldiers. Don't get careless just because they don't have much experience.
I thought using genetically modified soldiers was prohibited by international law.
Yes, but those are just declarations, not actual treaties.
The interesting thing is that nearly every member of the unit conspired in this attack.
Yeah, old Snake, it's always frustrated me, the explanations for how to justify his appearance as blonde there and that it's not really the case. It I think it was just a mistake.
How could an entire unit be subverted?
Something
to
was
rebellion?
Inconsistent.
They're calling it a revolution.
Since and justified later,
the same
I don't know.
Gene therapy,
never made
they
sense to me.
Felt closer than brothers. They
hearing
see
it explained
is their only family.
The son's a big boss. But if they were regular army, they must have been interviewed periodically by army counselors.
According to their files, they all got straight A's on their psychological tests. They all seemed like fine, upstanding, patriotic soldiers.
But they all took part in the uprising?
No. Several people didn't show up on the day of the exercise. That's why there was a resupply of troops.
Was there any sign recently that something might be wrong?
There was a report a month ago that they were acting strangely.
Apparently they consulted classified information about the soldier genes and performed their own gene therapy experiments.
They can do that even without you?
Well, our gene therapy process is almost completely automated. And besides that, they're all geniuses with IQs over 180.
Even the existence of this genome army is a national secret of the highest order. We've been hoping to investigate this thing quietly and deal with it behind closed doors.
Yeah, Procyon, I've heard it explained many times. DRK over at Outer Heaven loves to explain it. He hates when people bitch about it. What is it? Oh, he just gets his hair cut. He didn't dye his hair, he just got a haircut. I get it. There's nothing in the game to indicate he dyed his hair. There's also, as far as I can tell, the way that the art was created, that's not a good justification. Saying that it was just, you know, it was just lighting. It's just lighting in the room. It's reflecting off his hair. He's got... using soul glow. He's got grease in his hair. I don't know. Whatever. It doesn't make... Let's not talk about it. It's totally boring. Yeah, he looks blonde here, and he's obviously not during the game.
Your former unit.
Just leave it at that.
And one that I was a commander.
Totally not interesting, to be honest.
An elite group combining firepower and expertise. They're every bit as good as when I was commanding them.
So they're still around.
There are six members of Foxhound involved in this terrorist activity. Psycho Mattis, with
all the art here is very high contrast.
Sniper Wolf, the beautiful and deadly sharpshooter. Decoy Octopus, master of disguise. Vulcan Raven, giant and shaman. And Revolver Ocelot, specialist in interrogation and a formidable gunfighter.
Looks like a lovely bunch of folks. Too bad we'll be meeting under these circumstances.
And finally, in charge of them, Foxhound's squad leader, Liquid Snake.
Liquid Snake?
Yes. And you're the only person who can stand against him.
Snake, so one of the first infusions that people have with this series is who the hell is Snake? Solid Snake, Naked Snake, Liquid Snake, Solidus. There's so much overlap in the code names, as well as the relationships between the characters being pretty confusing and all intertwined. That's one of the hardest things for non-fans of the series to process when they're hearing people talk about the series. Who are all these people named Snake? A lot of people who don't know the series know that the series is about someone named Snake, but perhaps not that there's Snake and Snake and Snake and Snake. They're all the same Snake. Well, definitely throws people for a loop. We are Solid Snake.
Liquid Snake.
Who is Liquid Snake?
Liquid Snake. The man with the same code name as you.
Tell me what you know.
He fought in the Gulf War as a teenager, the youngest person in the SAS. His job was to track down and destroy mobile Scud missile launching platforms. You were there too, I believe. Didn't you infiltrate Western Iraq with a platoon of Green Berets?
I was just a kid myself back then.
The details are classified, but it seems that originally he penetrated the Middle East as a sleeper for the SIS.
He was a spy for the British Secret Intelligence Service?
But he never once showed his face in Century House. He was taken prisoner in Iraq, and after that there was no trace of him for several years. After you retired, he was rescued. And became a member of Foxhound.
I thought that by the time I left, they were no longer using code names.
I don't know his real name. That information is so highly classified that even I can't look at it. Here's a photo of him. Pretty shocking, huh? His skin tone is different, but otherwise you two are exact duplicates.
I have a twin?
I don't know the details, but it seems so. That's why we really need you for this mission.
You're the only one who can beat him. Now that I've met you, I know. You've got something that he doesn't. I can see it in your eyes.
Got something that he doesn't. Why it's in your blood.
Why don't I find that thought more comforting?
Clones just come out blonde. So many snakes. Saw this a few minutes ago.
Your scissors.
Nope.
What are you
going
to
do? You only get this if you go through them all, I think.
Don't worry. Just gonna clean myself up a little.
Huh? So you saw all his...
I don't want to be mistaken for the leader of the terrorists.
All his locks. He realizes he looks a lot like Liquid Snake from that picture he received. So he cuts his hair and go through the game with short hair. Short, dark hair. Alright. Alright. This is gonna be pretty painful. I've watched this game played many times. That's how I got into Twitch, was watching a couple of particular channels a whole lot. One of them was United, formerly United, the Outer Heaven Network. Lot of Metal Gear. How I got into the series. I was not a Metal Gear fan back when it was games were released, 98 and onward. The solid games. I had to discover it by watching other people. And I really got into the series, and I eventually had to play it. So it mentions here, radar off. That is not the only difference. I played this on normal once. Never played it on hard. I don't think from watching it all these times, I don't think I have the skill set necessary to breeze through this on hard. We're gonna crawl through this on hard. It's gonna hurt. Hurt me more, Snake! Make me feel alive again. Just remember the basics of CQC and you'll be fine. If only. CQC had not been invented yet.
I'm going to swap down a couple.
Chronologically, sure. But at the time this game was made, CQC wasn't a thing in the Metal Gear Solid world. You cannot simply knock your opponents out. You can choke them. But you can't CQC. KO Commander, how are you doing? The music in this game is epic, the voice work is fantastic, the cinematics are great, and if you consider that this was 1998, the graphics and use of 3D environments are exceptional.
Snake. Colonel, can you hear me?
Loud and clear. What's the situation, Snake?
Looks like the elevator in the back is the only way up.
Just as I expected. You'll have to take the elevator to the surface, but make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the select button. When we need to contact you, the codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the select button. The codec's receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
Got it. Okay, I'm ready to go.
This game does still look fantastic.
Patching it through.
BD Gray, thanks for the host. God, no radar. All right, fail count is back. You know, I don't really like using death counters in a lot of situations because it just demoralizes me if I'm screwing something up that badly. There's no radar. My God. Crouch, stand. I gotta relearn everything. Everything. And I'll remember where some things are and forget where most things are. So rations on hard, if I understand right, you can only hold two. You can never hold more than two rations. On normal, I think I took advantage of having a bunch of rations to get through some of it. If you have rations equipped when you're taking damage and your health drops to zero, you will automatically use the ration. And on normal, that will fill your health all the way back up. On hard, it will only fill part of your life bar. You also have a shorter life bar, and you can only hold two of them. So these things are going to be additional challenges. Normally, he's crawling into the water. Normally, the radar would help you see cones of vision for the soldiers. Metal Gear Solid 2 and beyond are a lot more open in terms of level design. Metal Gear Solid 1 has very restrictive, intentionally restrictive level design. Part of the problem with Twin Snakes that a lot of people have with Twin Snakes, the remake of this game, is that it uses the MGS2 engine, and mechanically, the game was so different that allowing people to aim and tranquilize things, aim certain ways and tranquilize things, didn't work for this game. The level design is meant to be restrictive and small. Each zone is relatively small, finding your way from the beginning to the end of each room or zone. Old Snake, it's more efficient to manually use rations. Yes, I imagine it would be more efficient. I should have been on the other side of the room by now. We're trying to get to that elevator that just came down. There's also, something down here. Isn't there? Besides the ration. No, I'm thinking of the beginning of MGS2. So while I'd still prefer if you ask before offering tips, I am okay with getting tips. I've not only seen the game many times, but have played through it before. I wouldn't mind knowing some things that would make this a little easier. Yeah, Snake. Old Snake. Only MGS2 should have a trank, really. It was designed for that game, and one was never meant to have a trank. So I just walked through a puddle. That can be heard. We can hear that they already heard me. The radar would let me know if I'm walking into another soldier over here. And someone who had played the game many times would probably be familiar with some of the pathing. I can go in first person mode and look at that guy who's about to see me. Alright, let's see. Oh, this is gonna suck. The death command, which I'm gonna use here to record that, is, I think, only available to mods. So don't everyone try to spam it, it won't even work. If I don't increment the death counter, or someone else doesn't increment the death counter, just let me know, let us know. We can always fix it. But, what was it? No, it's fail plus. I changed it from death to fail. No, let me check the command here. Good. We're good. You couldn't play this. The camera is bruh. It's gonna hurt more at the beginning while I just get used to playing again. Who knows? I mean, I might not be able to complete this on hard. I don't think you can change the difficulty partway through, though, so it would mean... Is that correct? It would mean, I think, a restart. If I decided to change the difficulty. So while you can look in first-person mode in this game, you cannot aim and shoot in first-person mode. That's one of those mechanical things that changed with the second game. And when Twin Snakes used the engine from the second game, it really changed the way things worked. Too much. This game was not built around being able to shoot in first-person mode or tranquilize people. I can pan the camera in first-person mode, but it's pretty awkward. You gotta use the D-pad. Yep, you can knock. Thanks for the reminder. Thank you for the reminder. I can. If I knock, I get spotted the wrong way. Be dead in just a moment. And you can fight, but you're not gonna... Old Snake, thank you for the follow. Welcome aboard. Alright, they're knocked out. I don't know if they stay knocked out. Or what exactly. On hard, there's a lot of things I'll just have to experience. Oh, come on. Hugging the wall right now. Well, that almost worked. Cutscene. Saved by the cutscene. They don't, like, 5 to 10 seconds on hard is all they'll stay knocked out for. Good to know. Who knows? We could be playing MGS1 all week. This could be a 50-hour run. Took me 18 hours on normal. Very, very lucky. Cheers, Old Snake. Welcome aboard. Battle Moses. We've done it in 6 hours on normal. I've definitely seen it done very quickly. Not having the radar is gonna be so painful. Guess the real you doesn't live up to the legend. Never does. It never does. Merle! Merle!
It's Snake. I'm in front of the disposal
facility.
Too soon
to talk about Merle.
That took a long time. I guess you're feeling a little rusty.
Don't worry. It's been a while, but it's all coming back to me.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska, you know.
Take it easy. I'm grateful. If it weren't for your suit and your shot, I would have turned into a popsicle out there.
An anti-freezing peptide, Snake. All of the genome soldiers in this exercise are using it.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that. Already tested, huh? By the way, how's the diversionary operation going?
Two F-16s just took off from Galena and are headed your way. The terrorist radar should have already picked them up.
Behind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
I have no idea, but it looks like our little diversion got their attention. Now's your best chance to slip in unnoticed.
Indeed.
There are only 18 hours left until their deadline. You've got to hurry.
Wow, he must be crazy to fly a hind in this kind of weather.
Who's that?
Oh, sorry. I haven't introduced you to yet. This is Mei Ling. She was assigned to us as our visual and data processing specialist. She designed your codec, as well as your Soliton radar system. Contact her if you have any questions about either of them.
Nice to meet you, Snake. It's an honor to speak to a living legend like yourself. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just didn't expect a world-class designer of military technology to be so cute.
You're just flattering me.
No, I'm serious. Well, I know I won't be bored for the next 18 hours.
Come on. I can't believe I'm being hit on by the famous Solid Snake. But I'm surprised. You're very frank for a trained killer.
Looks like we both have a lot to learn about each other.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to learning about the man behind the legend.
She designed our non-existent soliton radar.
We'll be monitoring your movements by radar, so contact us.
Oh, sure, you get a radar.
Got it. I'll call if I'm...
Can I borrow your radar?
Seriously, Snake, we're here to back you up, so call if you need some information or advice. I'm also in charge of your mission data. Contact me if you want me to record your current status. My frequency is 140.96. It's a dedicated frequency for saving data. Don't forget it.
Oh,
remember, except for your binoculars, you're naked. You need to arm yourself with whatever weapons you can find.
I remember. First, I'm strip searched by Dr. Naomi here, and then all my weapons are taken away. Imagine yourself put in that position.
Well, if you make it back in one piece, maybe I'll let you do a strip search on me.
I'll hold you to that, Doctor. By the way, sorry to disappoint you, but I did manage to smuggle out my smokes.
How did you do that?
In my stomach. Thanks to the shot you gave me that suppressed my stomach acids.
Cigarettes? How are those going to help you?
You never know.
Still automatic.
If you want to get in, there's the front door. It's the fastest way, but there's too much risk of being spotted by the enemy.
I can't just knock on the door and ask them to let me in. There's one sentry on the left and one on the right. They're armed with 5.56ers and pineapples.
What about the air duct near the door? There should also be a duct on the second floor.
I can't see it from here.
I'll let you decide the best COA.
Nastasha's codecs are great. And almost entirely optional. All right. Few things to do here. You can actually adjust the frequency on the codec yourself and try to call random things, but there are only a few things besides the ones that you actually pick up that the game tells you about and the people you come in contact with. There are only a few extra ones in there. Anyway, they're all remembered. So Meiling, save game. Nastasha is one of the characters you can talk to over the codec, over your radio, and she has a tremendous amount of information, very cool stuff on nuclear proliferation, deterrence, and it's all optional. There's a lot of codec calls in the first game that are not optional, in fact, more than in the other games. As the series progressed, you had a lot more of this stuff that you had to dig for if you wanted it. The first game, a lot of it was presented to you. Still though, a whole lot of things. The series is known for all its lore. And if you've just done something or looked at something and you call your superiors or your other contacts, a lot of them will have information about them, cool things to say. Some of them are considered Easter eggs. Some of them are really hard to dig through and dig for, but I don't know where they all are. I know where some are. If anyone wants to encourage me to dig out certain codec calls in certain places, if you know where they are and what they are, let me know. Nastasha's are 100% optional. Yeah, I don't know. Do you even meet her during one of the non-optional codec calls? Or is it 100%? Say 100%. Could have sworn you actually meet her during one of the regular codec calls. I hit the wrong button, so she's not voicing this. Snake, remember what De Gaulle said. The graveyards are full of indispensable men. Snake, you're all alone and surrounded by bad guys. Try to be careful and avoid getting into a fight whenever you can. You're right. Wow. You know all sorts of great quotes, don't you? Well, both my parents were from Guangdong, China, but I was born and raised in America. I've always liked reading literature from both sides. Kinda keeps me in touch. I'll share some more quotes with you if you'd like. I'm looking forward to it. But to tell you the truth, I'd like to learn more about you. Well, I'll think about it. very easy to hit a button during the codec calls that silences the codec, and then you have to click through it in silence. You can't get the voices back on once you've done that. It'll happen a few times. I'll try to avoid it. Starting the game. It took an hour to get the game started. Isn't that a thing? We've also had nearly 3 cups of coffee already. You want me to try and make an early call? 14152. Do you want me to call Nastasha right now? I can do that. Does she answer already? Do we have to get a little further in?
This is Nastasha Romanenko. A pleasure to work with you.
No one's told us we're working with her yet,
but... You're the nuclear specialist that the Colonel mentioned?
That's me. You can ask me anything about nukes that you want.
Anything?
I am also a military analyst, so I have an extensive knowledge of weapon systems as well. They asked me to participate in this operation as a supervisor from the Nuclear Emergency Search Team. I was happy to accept. We must not allow terrorists to get their hands on nuclear weapons of any kind. I hope I can help you to stop them.
You're a tough lady.
Those terrorists are serious about launching a nuclear weapon? The world cannot stand by idly and allow that to happen, and neither can I. Unfortunately, all I can do from here is provide you with information.
Hopefully that'll be enough. Another soldier here wouldn't make a difference anyway. It's good to work with you, Nastasha.
Same here, Snake.
We can now call her. She's on the list. We can call her anytime without having to punch in her number manually. But should we pump her for information now or wait a little bit? Silly as it might seem, I'm gonna save since we just spoke to her. We put Nastasha on the list. If I screw this up, I have to call her
What's
back
up,
to put
Snake?
Her back on the list anyways. We'll just save again. We'll get a little more from Mei-Ling. Mei-Ling loves to offer lore, little quotes, tips. Not lore. Lore was a little too broad for that. What Mei-Ling likes is to
Snake,
offer proverbs and advice.
He who knows
advice.
That enough is enough will always have enough. Just because you see an item doesn't mean that you always have to get it. If you don't really need it, think twice before you stick your neck out. It might not be worth it.
She will give a lot of tips. Notice how she said item. One of the things Metal Gear Solid is known for is breaking the so-called fourth wall. Characters in the game will talk about the fact that you're in a game in various ways. Don't rush the frequencies, they all get mentioned in due time. Yeah, I'm not trying to load it all up. Nastasha being optional is sort of an exception. And she's got all this dialogue you're not gonna be pushed into. When we're hugged up against the wall, we get a different camera view. You cannot free pan the camera. So the line of sight that Snake has is a huge part of how this game was designed, and the level design, not being able to see things unless you're in certain positions. A first person mode, well, Snake's facing the other way, he's not facing the box. I could look up against the box, but there's no leaning around corners. Closest thing to leaning around corners is this. You put yourself up against an object, and the camera will change positions, giving you a bit of a view. You can see a soldier off in the distance. Sekor, that's what I was wondering about. Doesn't Nastasha's frequency actually get mentioned and you meet her once and then the rest of her dialogue is all optional? In the 80s, B.D. Gray, actually, what would be the dates? Late 80s, early 90s for MGS, or for Metal Gear 1 and then Metal Gear 2. Someone would have to look that up. See the spotlights panning? Obviously, we don't want to be in the spotlight. Trying to see what's off to the side there. You see the soldier on the snow, on the raised snowbank? Should be able to get into the center area as the spotlights pan, and as long as I don't get spotted by a guard, it'd be possible to pick that up. I don't remember if that's chaff grenades or what it is. Notice how there's a wider gap between them. Not right now, but when they pan back one more time. I don't know if you walk through to the other side. Don't expect me to know correct patterns to do things. I'll remember that certain things are in certain places, and then I will royally screw the pooch trying to actually accomplish them. So prepare yourselves for that. Could have been a lot worse. Didn't actually get seen by a guard here. That was chaff grenades. When you are crouched, you can start crawling in first-person mode. And then you can go into first-person mode, which will happen automatically if you're underneath certain things. You'll go into first-person mode. Not the point, DJ Kikisa. I don't know what I do and don't need. Like I said, don't expect... Yeah, they are bait, but don't expect me to do things correctly. Don't fall for the bait. Well, I will fall for bait. I will walk face first into claymores.
Huh? Whose footprints are these?
I will get spotted when I have no business getting spotted. Gonna happen. I mean, you can point it all out if you want, as it happens. Oh, why'd you do that? Don't do that. Just don't expect me to process all the advice correctly, or in a timely fashion. I was waiting for the camera to pan to go up the stairs, but the guard who was beneath me... Heal and pick up ration. Yep. This is why I saved again, at least. Oh, it didn't actually... The save that I made after contacting Nastasha didn't save the fact that I had spoken to Nastasha. It's interesting. It was almost like a checkpoint save. I guess there are sort of checkpoints, and when you save, depending on where you're at, it doesn't save the entire world state. Yes, I had a chaff grenade. Indeed. Chaff grenade that I supposedly didn't need would have been very useful right there. Very useful. And yes, obviously it's a trap to get you to go up there and get spotted. At the same time, those are chaff grenades. I think they would be useful, could be useful. Going up this way, though, you'd have to pass the beam. There's really no way. We're talking grand. I say that right. Thanks for the follow. Welcome aboard. 87 for Metal Gear, 90 for Metal Gear 2, and it was 8 years before this. I'm gonna wait until I can see the guard on the snowbank, and I am gonna go for those chaff grenades. Pretty sure it's theoretically possible to not get spotted grabbing them. Trap or not, I think the timing does exist. And the camera wasn't what spotted me before anyways, it was that soldier. And they will see your footprints in the snow. So avoiding pathing in places where they're going to be pathing, pretty big deal. Yeah, Solid Snake was the name he was given at the very beginning. So it was not created for the 3D versions of the game. Solid Snake was not created for this. Shit. That was a good little screw-up right there. Come on. Oh, fuck. I had my chaffs. I just tossed a few chaffs. which might work for the camera, but I'm gonna get shot walking towards the camera anyways. So. Yeah, I'm not... Yeah, all good. We are all good. There's different control schemes for selecting weapons. I wasn't even thinking of how that functioned. I equipped the chaff grenades and then I went to try and knock someone out. Whatever weapon you have equipped, you're going to use with the same button that you would use to, you can call it CQC, but the game doesn't at this point. Not going to say CQC. Even accepting of the fact that I can't pan the camera, it's going to be ongoing frustration. You're right, I should use the ration, since I'm going to pick one up, can pick one up over on the side there. Makes all the sense in the world to just use one now. Can I hide over here? I think I can. Ah, that's what I wasn't thinking of. You can run through. It was open on the other side. Brain was trying to remind me there was something like that. I wasn't really processing it. I think that guard in the distance is actually sleeping. Remember right, he's asleep.
A surveillance camera?
A surveillance camera? So that chaff, if I used it in here, just as another example. So that camera won't spot me now. Grabbing those stun grenades. I don't know how long the chaff lasts, but I'm assuming not as long unheard. If you do the game on easy to get the bandana and unlimited ammo. I was just mentioning it, or was that a suggestion? Definitely don't have that going for me. So that guy is sleeping. He's also under a surveillance camera. So if I pathed in front of him, he might be sleeping, but the camera would see me. I could use another chaff. I'm gonna go up to that walkway entrance. I don't really know what I'm doing. There's no real plan here. Oh, fuck. It woke him up! Of course it did. The chaff grenade woke him up. Why wouldn't it? Why wouldn't it? It's loud. Hey Pete, what's up? Yeah, opening scene. That's why I put this on the break screen, because we're gonna spend the whole week on this scene. How do you like that? I'm not gonna wait for the guard to path around. I'm gonna just sort of risk it, see if I can strafe across here. Poor choice of words. See if I can run across here and just not get... Not like that, I can't avoid getting spotted. Probably walking down on the snow. He's gonna see me before I can even get out on the platform. I fear. Oh, okay. I don't wanna go back and around the snow now. Although if I go in here to grab the stun grenades, that might be a good plan. Fail counter, yes, I had it ready to go. I didn't wanna foretell the death by punching it in too soon.
Surveillance camera?
I could also just path carefully around this room. You don't have to use a chaff grenade to be able to get the stun grenade without being seen. It's just easier. I can successfully get back across. That's the big gap. That's the small gap. And that's the big gap. Whoa, fuck me. I missed the exit. Thought I could hide in the corner by the rail. Uh-uh. Question, and if anyone knows, feel free to give me an explicit answer. I picked up a couple items. When I saved after talking to Nastasha briefly, it did not save her codec.
You caught Snake?
Frequency. But I'm thinking the items I just collected would be saved. What parts of the world state are saved and which ones aren't? Because your location seems to be more checkpoint based.
Not had, all spent. What our desire is got without content. Basically, it means that your desire can get you into trouble if you're not careful. That goes for items, too. Don't get too greedy or you might be sorry. Be careful, Snake.
Fair enough. Only saves the checkpoint. No items. So that extra save is really pointless, then. Completely pointless. The guard just reset his position, or was running back to his position after the alert. Got the ration up ahead, and I can only hold a max of 2. May as well use that, heal, collect the one over here. And then, I gotta stick to this wall. When I moved away from the wall before, and then nudged the D-pad, that's when I moved too far out. The guard who comes this way saw me. I got freaked out because he kind of walked around the box.
Whose footprints are these?
Man, he heard me again already. Come on, move, Snake. Move your ass. Yay for D-pad control. So I can crouch. Gives me a little bit of cover. There's actually a guard up on this level. I don't remember. There might be. Might not be. You know you can play with analog. I don't think it will help me though, since the game was designed around the D-pad. Come on, fuck. Just trying to get inside. Zerg, Leroy! No, Leroy doesn't work in Metal Gear. PS3's D-pad sucks. I don't agree, and the analog would be really confusing for me. I think I'd have a lot of trouble with it. I like the PS3's D-pad. In fact, I like the DualShock 3 all around. I think it's a fantastic controller. I've had this one DualShock 3, and I've made a little repair on my own, but I've had this DualShock 3 for, I don't know, it's like when I got my PS3 Slim. It was the first type of Slim that they released, and I've not had to replace the controller. I've already been through a few DualShock 4s. See if I can just sneak around here.
Surveillance.
I need all this practice. This whole opening area, being stuck here for a while. No counter. I need the practice. So while it's there, I'm gonna hug up against this. Jimmy. And when it's looking towards the entrance, I'm gonna grab the grenades and then hug the wall again, hug the box again. Doable. Too bad the checkpoint saves me and I have to do all this over again, but the practice is good. I didn't take advantage, but that was the big gap. There's a smaller gap right now. They're not as separated. I probably can't make it through. If I go right now and I actually go out the right spot, almost. So there is that guard on the second level. But I couldn't remember if he was there, and he is. That's probably stupid, because he's gotta walk by. If I had moved quickly enough, I might have been able to get all the way to the stairs. Part of...
Whose footprints are these?
Shit. Come around this side, because... Bonk. Gonna see me from behind. Shit. Not good. Oh man. Oh man. Set pass, what's going on?
What can I do for you, Snake? I
wasn't trying to call you. Do not, well.
Good luck, Snake.
Yeah, that was pretty, pretty lucky. And I missed the incoming codec call, too. Because I wanted to get under there as soon as possible. Get Andy, how you doing? Welcome. God, it's so dark in here. BD Gray, okay, I'll have a look later. I'm so tempted to take my first break early because I need to pee really badly. I probably just should. I should. We made it in. We made it in here. I guess let's go a little further. We are in a vent. It's just as dark as it looks. How do you like those graphics? Now, the game really has exceptional graphics for its time, but there were limitations to what you could actually do in a place like this. Yeah, get Andy. I never played this when it was new. I played this for the first time last year.
Snake, this is McDonald Miller.
Eat Miller.
It's been a long time.
Master, what are you doing here?
I quit being a drill instructor, so I moved out here for some peace and quiet. I'm in retirement, just like you. Once in a while, I still help train the Alaskan scouts.
Passing on the skills to a new generation, huh?
Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about survival in a harsh environment. I've lived in Alaska longer than you, so call me if you have any questions about the flora or fauna out here. My frequency is
141.80. Yeah, having to pee introduces a sense of urgency. That it does. That it does. This game will change your life. Well, it sort of did watching it when I was new to Twitch. Huh? I watched a lot of Metal Gear Solid. Got to know the series quite well before ever playing it.
Just open the vent covers. We're about to start spraying for rats.
First floor basement ventilation shaft.
Shut those covers as soon as they're done spraying. Also, keep your eye on that woman in the cell. Don't get careless now.
Woman in the cell?
Woman in the cell?
Did something happen?
There's an intruder.
Really?
He's already done three people.
He's killed three people?
Yeah. Say he's using stealth, too.
Stealth? There's an intruder besides me?
Besides,
anyway,
it's not us.
I want you to increase the security detail on the chief.
So you can look through these vents if you're in the right position when you're crawling over them. You go into first person mode, at which point you can pan the camera. Not us. Not us. Someone else. There's an intruder besides us. Maybe he's letting us know we got killed 3 times. Yeah, I'm gonna get us killed many times. Find your way in this vent shaft. If you don't know where you're going, it's kind of crazy. What I'd like to do is spy on Meryl, the woman in the cell that they talked about. I'd like to spy on Meryl, but I'm not sure I know exactly where I'm going. A surveillance camera? Are you not a fan? Are you not a fan? Ekwar, not a Meryl fan. But Meryl! I think she's down there. There's also items down there. It depends on you. Please tell me she dies. Well, it depends on you. Are you asking me? Is that what you meant? Does Meryl die on this game? Like, am I going to get her killed? I'd prefer not to get her killed. I like Meryl. Also just got turned around. In my lane. I think that's where I drop down, and I don't want to drop down. Can I crawl past it to that item? I don't remember. Go back this way. I'm trying to figure out where Meryl's cell is and if we can drop in on her. You like Meryl? What's wrong with you? So evil. So evil. Alright, lurk on. Sid pass. See you later. The office I just came by, it is. This is the way I went. Came up here. Nothing to the right. Alright, then we came down this way. Maybe I passed it already. Maybe I can crawl over this hole.
Press the action button to drop down.
Implying that I can crawl past it, right? Good. Good. Can't remember if my health is full. I'm gonna go ahead and use. Maybe my health is full, perhaps. Meryl's cell is on a different floor. That later is when I crawl into a different vent later? Am I just jumping the gun here? They mentioned her, in the cell, and I just assumed we were there. Press the action button to drop down. I was trying. Oh, action, not weapon. Action, not weapon. Mm-mm.
Use the elevator to change floors. There should be a cargo elevator that you can take down somewhere around there. Try to find it.
Okay. First break is gonna be now. Let's call. Mei Ling, let's save.
What is it, Snake?
I'll come back. We'll make a few codec calls. We'll see if we can get some extra information and then proceed.
Snake, like Shakespeare said, knots had. All spent, what our desire is got without content. Basically, it means that your desire can get you into trouble if you're not careful. That goes for items, too. Don't get too greedy or you might be sorry. Be careful, Snake.
All right. Quick break. I'll be back. About 5 minutes. We're gonna have a fantastic break.